today we're mashing up bananas. Why are we mashing up bananas? Because here on Rooster Up, we do all kinds of crazy things. We don't care what we do.
Well, I was going to say, what are you getting your teeth pulled?
Yeah, we're getting some teeth pulled. Anyways, Mom and them had a whole case of bananas give to them, so I got about, two dozen, three dozen?
Somewhere in there.
Probably about 30 bananas I peeled, I chopped up. I took a tater masher, I mashed them up in this pan right here. So they're pretty small right now. So, and now I'm taking the blender right here and I'm going to blend them up real good. Mix them up. We got to be correct on our terminology, otherwise the truck police behind the camera here will get me.
Well, it's a mixer, it's not a blender.
It's a mixer, it's not a blender, because the correct police will get me.
Well, a blender chops things up, that's a mixer. Do we have to have that light on there?
Do what?
Do we have to have that light on right there?
No, not really.
Because it's right beside your head and it looks weird. Looks like it's too bright. Well, yeah, okay.
Is that the one you wanted off?
Yeah, because it was right there at your head and All right. It was looking weird on your head.
Get this down pretty smooth and fine. You don't want no real big clumps because you're trying to release the sugar, and it's what I'm trying to do. And I got the ripest bananas. Most of you people would have said they were ripe. That's what I wanted, was real soft, mushy banana. Y'all may be wondering, what the hell is this crazy ass doing today? Well, I'm telling you, I'm gonna bring me off a little banana moonshine is what I'm doing today. It's gonna take me about 2 weeks to get everything ready, but I'll get everything ready today. And then in 2 weeks when I come back from work, I'll steam it off.
Well, now you're getting the fermentation process started.
And the drink that I had right here is just plain old sweet tea. Ain't nothing special to it. For you blokes overseas, y'all have it in small cups, hot, with sugar and milk. That's disgusting.
Well, they said the same thing about your iced tea.
All right, we're getting her down real fine right here. And yes, this is my very own pot. Tracy, don't mess with this pot. It's mine. Pot. Yes, my hands are clean. I wash them multiple times. I always clean my hands. We ain't gonna do nothing today clean. Now, will your small lid fit on this pot?
I don't know. It might. I haven't tried to put it on there, so I don't know. But it's just sitting inside the pantry over there. Yeah, I was gonna say. You know, where you turn the dial for them to go up. Oh. You just push that straight in, the beaters will come out. And then that way you put the base somewhere else besides.
Well, the base needs
to be in the wiped. Gooey bit. The
base needs to be wiped down.
Well, yeah, it'll have to be. Well, I got glass mugs down there. Yeah. Because if that was too big, there's ones that are half that size.
Gonna use warm water. Gonna get it real nice and warm. Oh shit, I'm missing an ingredient. Where's my sugar bowl? Shut that off for a minute.
Good.
Got my big cup right here. We need 5 tablespoons of sugar.
Five doesn't mean heaping. That's closer to 2 when you're doing that.
Got 5 tablespoons of sugar right there. Miss Otto cracked behind the camera. Yeast with a Y. Not like my brother was saying.
Yeah, he'd be calling it East.
And we're going to have about 3 tablespoons of this right here, maybe 4. We're just gonna go with 3. And a half one for good measure. Alright.
Sun came out.
Sun came out. We're gonna get our water good and warm over here. Basically, what we're doing right here is we're activating the yeast with the sugar. We're just gonna stir it up.
Yeah, I was gonna say, make sure you scrape it off the edges.
Get the sugar and the yeast all mixed together real good. You know, I can already smell it working right there.
Well, you know, you could have gotten a wooden spoon out of that drawer. They'd been longer than that.
That's working just fine. This is normally my beer drinking mug. We can put them in the freezer, get them real cold. On a hot day, we fill them full of beer, drink beer out of them. About every second one, we'll swap them out and get a nice other cold one. Yeast in there we can get.
See where the handle is? There's some stuck to the...
I know.
That's what I keep seeing.
sugar off the bottom. Got that yeast going right there. I don't want it clumpy at all. I want this. It smells kind of like a banana bread mix is what I'm smelling.
Yeah, see, that's why the smell's not making me go, ooh, because it's bananas. Bananas are good for you.
Oh, this might not be too good for you when I get through with it.
Yeah, not that kind of banana for me. Bananas are good on lots of things. I mean, you can make banana splits or you make pancakes with them.
We're going to need about 4 pounds of sugar. Go ahead and turn that off. Shit, I wasn't recording. Oh, my yeast overflowed my cup right there, but that's okay. That's what it does. We ain't hurt nothing. Just keep your bowl handy. That way you can set your thing in a bowl there. And well, you'll see what kind of mess it makes right there, but that's all right. We're all good. All right, we got us 4 pounds of sugar right there, so Tracy says. And we're gonna go ahead and see what happens here. That's yeast and sugar and a little bit of water. We're gonna go ahead and dump our sugar mix in here. You probably wondered why I didn't do that when I was mixing up the bananas. I just didn't. Then you get you a spoon. It's gonna be a little tough to stir it, but that's all right. You wanna get it all mixed in real good.
Oh man, that smells good.
Does that smell good?
Mm-hmm.
Can I cook up some good stuff or what? I don't know, you didn't like my corn mash too well.
Oh no, that smell just made me oof.
Alright, now that we got the sugar mixed in there pretty good, we're going to grab our cup of yeast. We're going to mix this up in here. I can already smell the liquor coming off of that.
Really? Yeah, it almost smells like a rag that's been soaking in with bananas on it. You know, it's got that kind of wet rag kind of smell.
Then you won't give this a good stirring right here. Last time I did a corn mash, it came out pretty good. Yeah, that's going together real fine right there. I seen this other feller, he had some citric acid that he added to his for some reason or another. I don't know why. I wasn't paying that close of attention. What we're going to do, we're going to do about a half a teaspoon.
No.
Something about like that right there.
That is not half a teaspoon. Hey, never teaspoons that big. There is teaspoon measures over there.
We got our citric acid in there. We'll brush your hands off over here. We're going to mix it just a little more, get that mixed in with the rest of it. Get the bump pans out, we'll make us some banana bread.
Well, you got to add more to it than just flour and bananas and sugar. You make a banana bread, you got to get flour out.
It'll be some poke banana bread, I guarantee you that. Real fine. Go ahead and get your shot out there. Everything in this pot is edible. See the spoon right there? You get your little spoonful.
That's good. I told you, it's smelling good. Ooh, that's good.
That's good.
Banana nini.
I'm going to have to lock this up. Now, the next part is, we're just going to let this set right here for a bit and ferment. And we're going to clean everything up and just give her a wait.